that we did last year on the 924A. And I am happy to report that we definitely saw an improvement in the documents that we received from you this year. Notably, we saw an improvement in the number of regional centers that filed. And we had approximately 700 regional centers that needed to file the 924A this year, or we had 743 that needed to file, and 700 actually filed, which that's still a little shy of perfect, but it's up from what we had last year. It's 94%, we had about 90% filings last year. And so naturally, this decreased the number of notices of intent to terminate that we had to send out, reminding our regional center principals of their requirement to file, which is a good thing, because the less notices like that we have to send, the more time we have to spend adjudicating the other applications that we have in our office. Also, the compliance team, which is one of the new teams that we have at IPO, and they're the ones who handle the 924A review process, they reported to me that they are also seeing a decrease in the number of 924As that are getting filed at the wrong address. And I know that it's been a little bit confusing when we moved from California to Washington, and yet we still tell you to file some of your applications in California. So we did have a situation last year where a lot of our regional center principals were sending their 924A directly to us at IPO, and unfortunately we just had to either send them back or send them to California, because the intake and getting the things into the system that we need them to be in happens in California. We don't do that on site at IPO. And so good job, regional center principals, that did your filings this year. It did a much better job. There's a few other things that the compliance team asked me to share with you, since I mentioned to them that I would be talking to not only regional center principals, but there would be a decent amount of regional center principals here and attorneys that represent regional center principals. And they asked me to remind you of the need to notify IPO within 30 days of any management or structural changes in your regional center. Notification can be made by sending an email to the EB5 program mailbox. But we do ask you to do that as soon as possible. I will say too that better than sending us an email is filing an I-924 amendment. It's not required, but that's better than an email. Also, the team asked me to remind you to ensure that you're in active status. Your regional centers need to be in active status with one of the 50 U.S. state's Secretary of State. Also, to remind you of the naming convention, you're not supposed to use the DH seal or US in your title, and we just sent some information out about that in the last several months, and I do know that there's been a large compliance to that. Just a reminder to continue to comply with that direction. And then the last thing, well, not the last thing, another thing they ask you to share is, although it's not required, they would appreciate that the regional centers provide, in your 924A filing, provide a list of the name of the state that the regional center and related entities are registered in, as well as the state filing or record number. And here's a note, this is an important note for our regional center principals and attorneys. Once you file your 924A, you should expect to receive a receipt notice from USCIS within 3 weeks. If you don't, do not assume that you just didn't get the receipt notice, but we still got your 924A. Contact us. Contact us at our IPO customer service mailbox and let us know that you filed your 924A, but you didn't get a receipt. We'll do the research, and then we'll let you know if we, in fact, did get your 924A or if for some reason that we didn't. All right, and then one final